Hello everybody, this is Maciej from poshgui.com and today I will show you how to add events and code behind to your application. I have an empty form right here. I will just drag a button to the form and I want to detect when the user will click this button. So I will just select the button, go to the right side to the events tab and we can see a big list of events we can actually subscribe to. Let's choose the first one, click. Now we have to just write the name of the function that we want to have executed when the user will click the button. Let's call it onClick. Now we have to actually implement the function. Let's head to the logic tab. Logic is where you can store all of your events, all of your code behind. You have an editor on here that you can write your code in. And if you are writing a complex application, you have sections. So if you don't want to store everything in one file, you can imitate working on multiple files by adding sections. You can rename them. For example, you can have one for events. And if you are doing a lot of verification of the user data, you can, for example, write one called verification and store your functions there. When you are exporting the script, all of the sections are combined from top to bottom. That's why you actually can also reorganize them using this panel. Okay, let's implement our function. Function onClick. And for now, let's just write host. And user clicked me should appear in the console onClick. And that's all. We can go to output, export the script, and check if it's working. We have our button in here, and every time we click it, we can see that the console displays user clicking. So our event is subscribed correctly. Now, what if we actually want to read and write data to the UI? There are two ways to do this. I will show you one right now. And I highly recommend you check out other video of mine on data context, which provides another way that is more suitable for more complex applications. It's better at separating the logic and the UI. But for now, let's add a text box so the user can actually provide some input for us, and a text block so we can display the result of our function. Because we want to access these controls in the code behind, we have to name them. Let's select the text block and name it result. We will select the text box and name it user input. Because the controls have names, we can now head to the logic tab and access them directly. So now on click, I want to update the result. This variable now is the object of text block. I want to update its text property to say welcome. And I want to add user input text property to it. Let's check how it's working. We have our layout. Let's input my name into the checkbox. And we can see that the result text block is actually being updated with a nice welcome message. Now, what if I want to check if the user input is empty? Because I don't want to display a welcome message if there's no name provided. To do that, I just have to add an if in here, and I can check the user input text property. If it's equal to the empty string, let's add an else clause. So now if user provides some input, there will be a welcome message. If he doesn't provide input, I will just tell him you need to provide a name. Let's check how it is working. And let's provide an empty string. It's updating correctly by checking and verifying the user input. Now, one additional thing that I would like to have implemented in this one is what if the user will click Enter key? Because some users don't want to actually grab the mouse and click the button. If they are writing, they can just hit Enter and the application moves forward. To do that, we have to implement an event on the text box. Go to events, and from this big list, we will actually select an event called key up. So when you are hitting a key on your keyboard, key up is when you are releasing the key. Let's call it check enter. We need to implement this function. Let's go to the logic tab, function check enter. And now we cannot actually take the enter key from the user input text property because it will not be written there. This event is, as I've mentioned, executed when a user releases the key. And which key is this? Is actually provided in the event object. Every single function that you are subscribing to an event is getting passed two arguments. One is the object that is issuing the event, in our case the user input text box, and it is also issuing the event, so you can specify your parameters to access them. Here we can check if the event key is equal to return, which is the key code for enter. If it is enter, we should actually execute function onClick. So whether the user will hit enter or click the button, the result will be the same. Let's check if it's working. We have our layout. Let's first check the enter, and we can see that it is working. Whether you click a button or hit enter, the function will work the same. Thank you for watching. This is how can you actually can implement all of your code behind with events, with verification. But I highly recommend that you will watch the data context video also, as it provides an interesting way of doing that.